guys, today I wanted to talk about presets. When I say presets, I don't mean factory presets at all. I mean your own presets you create inside Bitwig to save time. And I never was a great preset creator for myself until I started to use Bitwig more and more. So I show you what I mean. I already created one instrument track here with a drum pattern, and of course one VST plugin which is called Addictive Drums 2, and it does drums. Which is nice, but every time I use it I have to select the right drum pattern, I have to select the right drum set, I have to select the right routing, and so on and so forth. And there's a much easier way. Of course you can save a preset inside the VST plugin itself, but then you only can save information that's inside your VST plugin. If you use Bitwig presets, you can add so much more information to it, and I want to show you that. So let's close this and add one preset of my own, which is called Addictive Polarity Drums. One advantage of using Bitwig presets is that you can save the modulators you attach to the VST plugin with the preset itself. I also added routing information to this preset, which means that I have separate outputs for kick, snare, head in here. And for every separate output, I have of course one Bitwig chain. So for instance, on this kick output, I have added one replacer, and in this replacer I have a e-kick, which means every time I play the kick drum, I also have played one e-kick. I also done this with the snare track. So the snare output generates audio, the replacer converts the audio into MIDI information, and the MIDI information triggers my e-snare synth. So every time I load this preset, I have already made some routings, I have some default chain set up, and I have some macros to tweak it. The macros are mapped to some parameters I always use when I start making drums. For instance, I have the snare track, and I can change the pitch. And not only the pitch of the e-snare synth in here, I also map this to this snare pitch. So I have the drum set itself pitched and the e-snare synth both at the same time. And of course I can change the amplitude of the synth and decay. Same for the kick. Because every time I start to make drum bass tracks, I know I always need some synths for the drums layered beneath a real drum set. I do this every time. And when I do this every time, there's pretty much nice to have a preset for that. And it can save you a lot of time. To save a preset, right click on the device itself, choose Save Preset to Library. Fill out the form and then hit OK, and then you're good. And maybe it gives you some idea what you can do with presets inside Bitwig, and you can try it for yourself. Maybe you have some tasks you do every time, and think about what you do a lot inside your application, and try to save presets or use presets to save time. Yeah, that's pretty much it for the day, guys. So if you learned something, then please leave me a like or ask me some questions in the comments. And of course, subscribe to the channel. Until next time, see you and bye.